Right, so welcome to a new episode of my Kerbal Space Program Career Mode videos, where today Jebediah Kerman is gonna go on his historic mission to become the first Kerbal in space. So let's head into the mission control to take a look at our contracts from the Career Evolution Contract Pack mod, where unfortunately before we can actually get the contract to get one Kerbal into space, we have to do the, I think that's what I'm showing right now in the All Contracts menu, where we can see that before we can get a Kerbal into space, we have to get a Kerbal to the upper atmosphere yet. So yeah, before Jebediah Kerman can go on his historic mission, we will have to do one more launch, which will be like, yeah, similarly to the last episode, one more test flight of the Mark 1 spacecraft. So let's go into the VAB and load the Mark 1 spacecraft that you can also find in the Steam Workshop. I'm going to put the link in the description. And so yeah, what I'm doing there now is removing basically the second and the third stage, so we will only launch the Mark 1 spacecraft with its, yeah, I mean like its service module on altogether three solid rockets. And based on the number of missions, we have selected Valentina Kerman to do this flight because she hasn't nearly as much missions as Jebediah Kerman yet, so to just balance it a little bit more equally. And we can now again replace the decoupler with a separator because I do not have unlocked the 60 centimeter size decoupler yet, and yeah, also already giving the order to build the actual Mark 1 spacecraft for the first orbit of Jebediah Kerman. So leaving the VAB and going to the launch pad a couple of days later, after the first test spacecraft has been built, we can already commence the test experiment from the Nehemiah orbital stuff thingy mod from the Kemeny experiments. So it will be ready when we hit the upper atmosphere. And yeah, we have to commence the gravity turn really hard and have to yaw quite really early, and have to yaw quite hard to the east to make it a real flat flight profile, not going high, because of course the spacecraft has to really has to stay inside the atmosphere, because in order to actually get the contract to go into space, going a little into the IVA and enjoying the beautiful insight in the preview area from my Mark 1 pod, and also listening to the chippers from the here, the screaming vibration, and of course looking at the reflection of the observatory. And yeah, well, what was I? Yeah, we have to make sure that we, or not only make sure that we stay out of space, and also I wanted to make sure to stay like below what the Final Frontier mod considers Mach 3, as long as we are beyond, or we are under 30 kilometers of altitude, because I have like one more mission already up on my mind with some rocket planes to like make it a challenge to beat Mach 3. So just like an excuse to fly some rocket planes. So yeah, actually there was my phone. As you can or as you have seen, Valentina Kerman had to fly a little bit down, and there you can hear the dang it bot, where a battery failed, but I think one of four pieces or something like that of batteries having failed isn't even no big deal, it's just no deal at all. And yeah, actually Valentina Kerman had to fly quite a bit straight down in order to keep the spacecraft from getting into space, and then do yet another burn to like extend the trajectory and make it fly a wider distance. And already decoupling the service module, and this time we can retract the antenna because the command pod is controlled by a pilot, unlike the last episodes, and having completed the test experiment and again speeding things up in order to keep the video relatively short and all sound effects going a little bit pitched up at 4 times time lapse. And yeah, once we hit 30 kilometers of altitude, unfortunately my goal of staying below Mach 3 has failed, so Valentina Kerman now has the Mach 1 rim ribbon, but anyway, we still can do my concept rocket plane mission with Jebediah Kerman later. So deploying the parachute and still plummeting down, or now parachuting down until we get close to the water surface of the ocean, which yeah only becomes visible because with the landing information marker from the Kerbal Engineer mod, because it is absolutely dark. And yeah, successfully having splashed down after her flight to the edge of space at something like 68 kilometers of altitude, we can go back into the mission control and actually accept a really historic and exceptional contract where, unlike me, you can read how much funds and especially reputation it rewards, but it actually is quite a lot, and we can in fact accept two contracts, one to reach space and one to reach orbit, both of course with immense spacecraft, because we already have done these things before with some unmanned stuff. And the battery failure actually kinda reminded me of the Dang It mod that the next failure might be something more serious, so I added this injection module from the Vanguard, whatever my English pronunciation is horrific, technology mod that adds this parachute. So we are back at the launch pad. And again, as usual, deactivating for science, or as mostly usual, except when doing some atmospheric research with planes, and lifting off again. And yeah, I actually wanted to, or should have added, and wanted to have added the parachute ejection module before already with the first manned test flight, because of course it is very reasonable to do so, but I just might have forgotten a little bit about the safety of my Kerbals. So yeah, going up at dawn or at the sunrise, which is quite a good thing in fact, because it will ensure that like a few minutes later everything will be brighter, and then when the spacecraft lands a few minutes later, we can actually see what's going on. And I really like to look out of the window from IBA when piercing through the cloud, and then suddenly the sky turns from blue to black, and of course also to listen again to the ship effect, which I have only installed recently, so still like not become routine to me yet. So does the Chatterama. And again, staging and carefully keeping the rocket so great in order to prevent it from flipping around, and to make sure that we are going to space today. So yeah, I just can see right now that I might have forgotten to, I mean, I placed the cut in the video, but I might have forgotten a little bit to actually speed it up to 4 times speed, so you can hear the rocket at its actual sound. And having burned out and cut off, or burned out the second stage, we will very soon jettison it and activate the third stage, with the Terrier engine, and again speeding the video up by 4 times time lapse just to keep it short, but it is not as short as it could have been. And yeah, now not circularizing yet. The final orbital inversion will be done with the service module engine. But yeah, getting close to orbit. Insertion going with the spark engine, which is really awful noise, and yeah, doing some final corrections. And there already was shortly before the final Frontier mod where the very shiny and fancy first Kerbal in space ribbon appeared for Jebediah Kerman. And again, enjoying the look out of the window before doing some science, because I actually might have forgotten a little bit about doing two or three experiments with the Stay-Putnik suborbital things before. And we can also collect a little bit of science from the that still remains from the mystery goo pots, but nothing is left in the thermometer and I think also in the barometer. No, there's actually quite a lot of science left. I cannot read anything, so I cannot read it out, and you have to read it, but I can see that there is a lot of science left. And so yeah, closing the service bay again, and then I think I was taking some pictures there when I was rolling the spacecraft. And so yeah, reading about the recovered stages and everything, and the time lapsing, time warping. It was time warping a bit before the Kerbal alarm clock goes off to notify us about the, was it D5 or something, experiment of the Kimini experiments from the Nehemiah orbital science, orbital engineering mod. And yeah, I cannot read it, you can, so if you like it, unfortunately I cannot help you, you have to read it yourself, which I hope isn't a big deal. And yeah, if you don't like reading, maybe you have to search for some other games in the space program. And yeah, taking one last look out of the window, because I think we already are in the orbit there. Which, yeah, this is the orbit there, which I actually tried to do from IBA by just looking at the list on IBA. And yeah, like splashing down somewhat eastwards of the KSC and activating for science for a brief moment in order to transfer all the scientific results into the Mark 1 command pod, which gets which lands on a parachute and gets recovered while the service module splashes down hard. So any reports that remain in the service module will be gone forever. And yeah, we now hit the atmosphere, so we can jettison the service module, retract the antenna. I think I already have done it, or maybe I forgot again, I don't know. And once again hit the time lapse at 4x speed in order to keep the video short, where we can see how we overshoot the KSC, overshoot our ideal landing area in the sea of the KSC. But of course I especially now with the little spacecraft that do not require a heat shield, and because they don't have a heat shield, they don't have a wing surface area, and they are not aerodynamically controllable. And this will all change later with the more advanced spacecraft. We will also unlock the landing guidance function of Mechchev, which then allows us to actually see a prediction where we would come down, including the aerodynamic forces and or aerodynamic braking effect, which comes very, very handy at precision landing some space pods that do not have wings. So yeah, we have successfully splashed down. After the very historical mission, you can now see the scientific results. I think it was not so much, but of course this is more like the prestigious thing. And yeah, also see the refunds, which could have been better if we landed closer to the KSC. But I always prefer to land a little bit further away from the KSC in order to just make sure that we splash down into the ocean. So Jebediah Kerman has gained 1 XP and or 1 more XP and advanced to level 1. And you can now again see all the ribbons, like the first Kerbal in space and the fast orbit and everything. And yeah, as usual, if you have... Ah, no, no, wait, there's still some time left. I do not have to make the final speech yet. So yeah, you can see the fast orbit ribbon for less than 250 seconds and first Kerbal in space, everything, and Kerbin orbit ribbon. And so yeah, now if you have enjoyed this video, I would appreciate if you leave a like and subscribe to my channel. And you can also check out my main channel, which is linked on my channel page and also is linked here. And yeah, I hope to see you again in the next episode, where we are going to launch some the first probes at some other worlds, to the moon and to Minmus and to Kerbal. So yeah, I hope to see you again in this next episode.